see you in the summertime.
Change of heart. Oops, what's going on? I should get more involved in what I'm doing. Here we go. All right. Hey, Debbie wanted me to do a McFly that was a cover of a Queen song. She's very specific about the a venue. And the Queen song was Don't Stop Me Now. I did do a reaction, but I'm not going to post it because it was the only thing I could get that I could do was with one of those camera held things. I am going to do the reaction on Dancing in the Dark, because that's also a cover done by McFly. And the reason that this, I just saw the Dancing in the Dark when I was looking around for the Don't Stop Me Now. And the reason, and you know, when I was suggested to do Don't Stop Me Now, I'm like, man, I was familiar with the song from Queen, and I gotta tell ya, you know, it's sort of like a show tune or something. It's not, it's like something you'd see on a Broadway musical or something. Don't stop me. So I was a little skeptical anyway, but you know, who knows? You know, a lot of times people can make great songs out of, you know, not very good songs. Probably the most notable was Red Wine that UB40, of course, made into a monster hit. That was originally done by Neil Diamond. And if you go to the original Neil Diamond version, it's just dumb. I mean, Neil Diamond's, you know, Sweet Caroline and all that sort of thing. I mean, he's got a million hits, not only for himself, but that he wrote for other people. I mean, so he's Neil Diamond. But Red Wine was not one of his better efforts. And UB40 made it into a massive hit. Although they were doing a cover of a cover because there was a really good ska band in Jamaica that originally did it in the sort of ska reggae form. And so they sort of borrowed that. And even their cover version wasn't original. But anyway, so it can be done. So I did listen. And then Dancing in the Dark, that's by Bruce Springsteen. And, you know, oh my God. When that song came out, I mean, I was young. I was really, really young. And I'm just like, what? This is dumb. And that part, dee, 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 dee. It's just like, oh my God. I just couldn't figure out who. It was like the most gutless song I ever heard. But anyway, it was a massive hit and blah, blah, blah. So anyway, I thought, hey, this is a good opportunity to take now two songs that I really didn't like, and see how McFly, if the band McFly could breathe a little life into it. And as I said, I did do a reaction to the Don't Stop Me Now, but I'm not gonna, I probably won't post it just because of that handheld thing, but I will say this. I was pretty stunned because McFly took that thing that should have been, in, like I said, a show tune or something, and gave it a little bit of soul and a little bit of, you know, it's like a rock and roll song now, the way McFly did it. It's kind of, you know, it's they took something that was really, in my opinion, somewhat questionable and made it tolerable, let me put it that way. So that was a nice surprise, and it just goes to show you what four skilled musicians, not that the Queen guys aren't skilled, I mean, I like them. I mean, those guys are the top at the top at the top. It's just that song was kind of silly. It reminds me of my friend when I was really, really young, might have been 7 or 8, I mean, I was young, and I was asking this guy, Lloyd, he was a real good guitar player that was like at some school where my sisters went or something, and so I'm like trying to act cool. Hey man, you know, Queen, you know, Tie Your Mother Down, you know, that album's like so good. I think it's a Day at the Races. I can't remember. Anyway, and Lloyd looked at me and says, oh yeah, I guess, I suppose, you know, I mean, it's not really rock and roll, but I guess, whatever. I was like a little stunned, like, man, I thought Queen was like a really good band, and then here this guy's like so harsh, like blah, whatever. So in that sense, I was I was impressed with McFly's treatment of that. And now let's see if they can do something for Bruce Springsteen's Dancing in the Dark. And this is that radio thing they were doing at the beginning of their new tour. And we'll see if these guys can resurrect or impress me. Not that I'm anybody that they need to impress, that's for sure. With this Bruce Springsteen song that I've always disliked. All right, here we go. All right, I'm back. It's already better with that leg done on the guitar. It's already better.
I get up in the evening and I ain't got nothing to say. I come home in the morning.
All right, you sing it in a low style.
I go to bed feeling the same way. I ain't nothing but tired. Man, I'm just tired of blowing myself. Hey there, baby. I could use just a little help. You can't start a fire. You can't start a fire without a spark. The skirts for hire. Even if it's dancing in the dark.
It sounds better with a real rock and roll band.
Message keep getting clearer. Radio's on and I'm moving around the place. I check my look in the mirror. Wanna change my clothes, my hair, my face. And I ain't getting
very nice, very nice.
Man, I'm just tired of a dump like this. Something happening somewhere. Man, I'm just sure there is. You can't start a fire. You can't start a fire without a spark. This goes for higher. Even if it's dancing in the dark.
Very nice arrangement, very nice.
Even if it's dancing in the dark.
It's very nice. Very nice.
Sitting around getting older. Here's a joke and it's on me. Shake the world off my shoulders. Come on, baby, they laugh on me. Stay on the streets of this town. They'll be carving you up, alright. They say you gotta stay hungry. Hey, baby, I'm just about starving tonight. I'm dying for some action. I'm sick of sitting around here trying to write this book. I need a love reaction.
The arrangement of the guitar is very good.
Can't start a fire. Can't start a fire.
This guy's so good.
Spark. This goes for higher. Even if it's dancing in the dark. Can't start a fire. Worried about your little world falling apart. This goes for higher. Even if it's dancing.
No Austin Steve. Didn't see like who I look at. Poor guys. This is such a tough gig you can do.
Thank you so much, Virgin Radio. We've been McFly. Thanks for the support. Enjoy the album.
Gonna get the stadium treatment. Oh my god. Wow. Okay. Holy moly. First of all, it's kind of interesting, the very first verse, you see he was a little bit sketchy on the vocal. And, you know, like drifting around a bit, like, oh, man. And then, you know, when he got into the chorus, and that's why I really want to hear the second verse, and he just nailed it. Everything's good. I mean, and plus tough gig, you know, no audience. Anyway, very nice. Yeah, this arrangement is so much better than the Bruce Springsteen version of the Bruce Springsteen song. So this was kind of nice. I have to say, I didn't say it in the beginning, but this is definitely what I'm thinking, certainly from what I was talking about at the beginning of this reaction. Certainly I went in negative, because it's like there's no resurrecting this crummy song. The other one, that was, these guys should be called Dr. Frankenstein for bringing things back from the dead. Anyway, I gotta say, I'm very, not just change of heart from negative because of the material, but change of heart, these guys really, what's nice is, it's just so simple. It's four guys, four instruments, and it just goes to show you what you can do. I mean, speaking about four guys, four instruments, the Queen, I mean, don't get me wrong, that's an amazing band. I mean, what's that band, song, Stone Cold Crazy? I mean, you don't get more rock and roll than Stone Cold Crazy. So, I'm not really bagging on Queen, I was bagging on that one song. Anyway, I gotta tell you, I get more and more more impressed with these guys. I'm really glad that they're back together, I'm really glad they're touring, and I'm glad that everybody's showing up to the shows and buying the records, and everybody's having a good time. And I gotta say that rarely does a group of four people show up that's just like, wow, these guys are the real deal. The only other guys, but they weren't really a band, was Steely Dan. You know, whenever they did anything, it was just like, wow. I mean, they had the best guys, and again, that wasn't really a band. That was more like a couple of guys writing songs, and then they get guys to play and that sort of thing. So, a little bit different thing. That reminds me, oh, speaking about Neil Diamond, that's funny. So I'm watching this thing from flipping the Hollywood Bowl, and it's just like, they were phenomenal. He had like, you know, 15-piece band. I'm just like, God, man, they were just so amazing. I mean, he's a great performer anyway. I'm just like, how does a band just sound so good? And then he's like, hey, let me introduce the band. And he starts with the guitar player, and it was Hadley Hockenhull. I'm like, oh, well, that's how you sound good. You call Hadley Hockenhull up, and boom. Anyway, and then everybody else in the band were at the same level. I didn't even listen to the rest of the introductions. I just listened to that, and it's just like, well, they went out, and he just had the phone book that was called The Best Guys on the Planet, and then looked them up and hired them for this tour. Anyway, just a little aside. Hey, have a great whatever you're having, and thanks for watching, and please, if you can, buy some records from me, you know, see my websites in the description. Please, buy a couple albums. It always helps out. Thanks, and I'll see you next time.